My name is Jakob Isbosethsen, and I have been working for the government of Greenland for the past 10 years, and I'm the newly appointed head of representation in the Greenland Representation in Reykjavik in Iceland. And I'm very glad to be here and to make a short presentation of Greenland and a small showcase of our international work and collaboration. So, Your Excellencies, this is Greenland and our neighbors. To the west, we have Canada. We have the USA, we have Iceland to the east, and Europe. I would like to highlight some key facts and figures about Greenland. The size is about 2 million square kilometers, where almost 85% is covered by the Greenland ice cap. And to compare it to a European country, the size of Greenland equals 4 times the size of France, or the ice-free landmass of Greenland is twice the size of the United Kingdom, or another comparison is that the length of Greenland is from the south tip of Norway to the beginning of Sahara in Africa. So it's a huge country, and the population density is one of the lowest in the world, with only 56,000 inhabitants. And we have no roads, no trains connecting the cities, the towns, the settlements, which means that if you're going to visit your friends or your family, you have to go by small fixed airplanes, helicopters, by ferry, or by your own boat in the north. You can do it by dog sledging if there's ice enough. So the infrastructure is generally a challenge for us. Just to highlight here some few important milestones and cooperation areas that we are a part of. The Ilulissat Declaration states that we want to have a peaceful and sustainable development of the Arctic region according to international law, which has been signed in Ilulissat in 2008 and reconfirmed again here in May this year, in 2018. And I will also say that the Arctic Council is our most significant and important international forum. So who are we and the Ministry of Foreign Affairs in Greenland? Well, this is a bit boring map. We are in total approximately 21 persons, but in reality we are around 10 persons in the daily working with the Arctic Council, international climate change, Brexit, the EU, security and defense according with the framework within the Kingdom of Denmark, indigenous people's rights with the UN, with the IWC, and so forth. So there's plenty of work to do. So with only 56,000 inhabitants and a small administration, you can say we can always lose on points in terms of financial and human resources. So how do we deal and strike with the balance and represent Greenland and our interests for the benefit of our population, for our people in our international cooperation? Here's a picture of roughly half of our ministry gathering to the Arctic Circle in October in Reykjavik with our Minister for Foreign Affairs, Anne-Lone Bakker, in the middle. We also do a substantial cooperation with the other ministries in the administration, in the government of Greenland. We also work closely together with the Ministry for Foreign Affairs within the Kingdom of Denmark in Copenhagen, and also with the Ministry of Defense, where we have the Joint Arctic Command, which headquarters is situated in Nuuk in Greenland. We also have a significant fisheries export to China, Japan, and Korea, and they are very important trade partners in that relation. And we hope to that we could expand this cooperation also even further in the future. And we also have Greenlandic trade shows and exhibitions in both China, Japan, and Korea, with focus on export, trade, investments, research, and tourism. But it's also important that our partners and friends is visiting us in Greenland as well. Here we have a picture of the former president of Korea in 2012, Lee Myung-bak, and we also have the former U.S. Secretary of State, John Kerry, visiting Ilulissat where we were discussing areas of mutual interest and where he could experience the climate change, because that is what we feel, we see it, and we live just in the middle of it. We also used the opportunities, together with the Kingdom of Denmark, in relation to the Arctic Council meetings, to arrange bilateral meetings, here with also with the former US Secretary of State in Alaska and Fairbanks last year. We also had the former President of the European Commission visiting Greenland in 2007. We also recently had the President for the European Union, Donald Tusk, in Greenland. And we have also had the pleasure of having the former UN General Secretary Ban Ki-moon visiting Ilulissat and Uummannaq in 2014, where we also go to the UN General Assembly and talk about indigenous people's rights. Greenland and the EU is one of our most important international partners in our international cooperation. As you may know, Greenland was a part of the European Union but withdrew as so far as the only country in the world in 1985. And since then, we have had a historical and important relations together with the European Union in relations to fisheries and our partnership agreement on focusing on education and research in Greenland, and also as an associated member of the overseas countries and territories to the European Union. We also go to the European Union, to the Parliament especially, and highlight our right to wear and use sustainable sealskin, also to export to the European Union. We also have examples of all the European countries, member countries, ambassadors visiting Greenland and Ilulissat, discussing our relationships. And of course, we are not doing that for fun or for anything else than to show that when we are dealing and negotiating and trading with our international partners, that they can have an understanding on how our conditions are, what challenges we have, what opportunities we have. And it helps when they are deciding, sitting with 27 other member states, for instance, in the European Union, to see we have been in Greenland, we have been talking with the small fishermen on the harbor and in Ilulissat, we have been talking with the children, with the teachers in the schools in Greenland. So this is important for us, we know how it is, and this is not just something blur, a white thing up in the high north. I would also like to highlight that Iceland opened a general consulate in Nuuk in 2013, and we have a very good and strong relationship with Iceland. Both the US and Canada used to have diplomatic representations in Greenland under the Second World War. But for the first time since Iceland opened their diplomatic office in Nuuk in 2013. So it is possible to establish diplomatic missions in Greenland, also for Asian countries and for other countries. We have established Greenland representations in Copenhagen, to the EU in Brussels, in Washington DC and in Reykjavik. And it's very important for us to do promotion, to talk with our partners and explain how our challenges and opportunities are in Greenland. Here our example of our colleague in Washington DC, who is doing a substantial work with the Wilson Center, for instance, just to take an example in Washington DC. We opened our representation here in Reykjavik 1 month and a half ago, and here we have also Senator Lisa Mikowski from Alaska, together with the Icelandic Foreign Minister and our Greenlandic Foreign Minister. And Lisa Mikowski has been advocating for opening a US General Consulate in Greenland as well. And finally, there's just some pictures here with our Foreign Minister talking with the Japanese and the Chinese ambassador to Iceland, and other diplomats and ministers have the opportunity to come and meet us and talk with us. Our parliament just decided 10 days ago that we will have new runways in Greenland, 2,200 meters international runways in Ilulissat and Nuuk, and an international runway in Raotor in South Greenland. And we have also done our national shipping company have made a joint cooperation with the Icelandic IMSKIP. So I think that in the next couple of years, maybe the next 10 years, we'll see a substantial change in our development, at least opportunities for a new development in Greenland with these new facilities and cooperation. So with the limited time in conclusion, I hope that even though that we have a small administration, a limited human resources and a small country in that sense compared to our neighbors, we try to make our best out of our influences as much as possible for the benefit for our people, our population, which live and use the resources available in our country and region. And I hope this presentation has also shown you how the government of Greenland, in cooperation with the Kingdom of Denmark, is contributing to a peaceful and meaningful international cooperation, whether we are talking about North America, Europe, or Asia. It is important that we can show and contribute to a fact-based sustainable development for our needs in the Arctic region, a region that we call our home. Thank you very much.